And in a big message to China, the first glimpse of 8-wheeled armored personnel carrier was seen at the Leh airfield. Although the army has been operating such personnel carriers before, this latest entrant is just another ballgame.
The first glimpse of the armored personnel carrier for infantry troops at the Leh airfield. Conceptualized by the Defense Research and Development Organization, the Wheeled Armored Amphibious Platform is a multi-purpose troop carrier for reconnaissance and assault operations. The DRDO-designed armored personnel carrier was airlifted to Leh for high-altitude winter trials. Now, this vehicle will undergo very extensive trials, not just here in Leh at an altitude of 11,500 feet, but also at Depsang in DBO at much higher altitudes in extreme cold climate to see how the engine and systems on board perform. Though the Army has been operating the tracked version of the armored personnel carrier for decades, and it is even manufactured in India, the wheeled version comes with multiple advantages, especially in this high altitude terrain. The obvious difference between the wheeled vehicles and the tracked vehicles is that unlike the metal tracks on tanks, wheeled vehicles have multi-axle wheels, enabling them more agility and multi-terrain mobility.
In fact, this is one area which is very good for armor go, and it permits the armored personnel carriers. We have a choice of a tracked or the wheeled. In fact, here what matters is the speed. And this area is actually very suitable for wheeled personnel carrier, and is also suitable for the light tanks. And the existing tanks that we've got are even more powerful in this scenario. So I think we've got to make best use of what we have. And I think the wheeled personnel carrier will achieve an excellent advantage in this area.
The wheeled version is lighter and can be airlifted on board the C-17 Globemaster and underslung Chinook helicopters. The wheeled versions can move faster and can effectively be deployed both for reconnaissance operations and for quick redeployment of frontline fighting soldiers.
More importantly, in India, with the DRDO and Tata's coming together, Kessler or WAB, whatever you name it now, is under trials, and it has gone through in the area of Sikkim earlier, Ahmednagar firing ranges. It is being now under trial in Ladakh. And I'm quite sure it's a very potent platform because it has got multiple options of turret replacements and 8x8 vehicle, all-terrain capable. And it will be a very important vehicle in the use by the military. And it can be used by the infantry for carriage of troops. Section plus two can go inside that vehicle.
The new armor fighting vehicle can carry up to 12 soldiers, including the driver. And the aim of its deployment would be to ensure high mobility, firepower, and protection for troops inside the vehicle. The vehicle comes with anti-tank guided missiles and 30mm cannon. These vehicles can extensively be deployed in Chumar and Demchok in the south, in the Pengongso Lake area, the amphibious, and also on the other side in Depsang and DBO, where they'll play a very critical role, not only moving men from one place to another, but also, if required, for offensive operations and occupation of vital points and vital assets. With cameraman Kripal Singh in Ladakh, Gaurav Sawant for India Today.
Hello everyone, this is Rahul Kamal here. Hope you enjoyed this video. For the latest news and analysis, like and subscribe the India Today YouTube channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated.